Come, let us go into the house of the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul, all that is within me. Bless his holy name. The Lord is good, the Lord is kind, the Lord is merciful. The Lord is the reason why we're here this morning. Not anything that I've done, not anything that you've done, it's because of the goodness of the Lord that we're here this morning. As we enter the worship service, Lord, and in the presence of the Lord, there's fullness of joy and everything we need. Healing this morning to the Lord's presence, for the word of God said, by his stripes, we're healed this morning. Restoration to the Lord's presence, for the word of God said, he's going to restore to us the years that the mama worm, the kangaroo worm, the caterpillar has stolen from us, the locusts have stolen from us. God not only wants you to be saved, but he wants your household to be saved. God wants to make you 1,000 times better this morning. Oh God, we say thank you today. God, we say thank you. God, we say thank you for all things today. Thank you for the man of God. Thank you that he's out there strong and anointed, Father God. Thank you that he's protected, Father. Thank you for the mothers this morning. Oh, the brothers, the sisters, the saints, Father God. Thank you for the saints here, there, and everywhere, Father God. Oh God, we thank you today. Thank you, Father God, for safety and protection, Father God. Against the storms, the wind, the rain, Father God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you against drunk drivers, Father God. Against drivers, Father God, we thank you today. God, we say thank you. 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 Thank you today, Lord Jesus. Thank you today, Lord. Lord, we worship you today. Lord, we worship you today. Thank you, Father God. We thank you for all things today. Thank you, Lord. Let's worship the Lord this morning. Let's worship the Lord.
Worship the Lord. Come on, clap your hand and let's worship him this morning. Come on and worship him. Come on and praise him and worship him. Tell your neighbor, I came to worship him. We worship Christ, our Lord. I know we've sung this a minute time, but come on, lift your hand. We worship Christ, our Lord. We lift our hands to him today. We worship Christ our Lord. Come on, really look at the tip of your hand. I will worship Christ our Lord. I'm going to worship him.
Come on, make it deeper. Oh, be mine. Be mine. Y'all didn't know we needed you. I didn't know we needed you. We didn't know we needed you. We is in the school. We is in my college. We is on the street. Let's walk in power. Walk the walk in power. Go ahead, keep in power. Don't you know it's sweet? Help find your power. Don't you know it's there? Help find your power. My Lord, my Lord, yeah. My Lord, my Lord. My Lord, my Lord, yeah. Yes, it's keeping our children. Yes, it's keeping our children. In the school. Yes, it's keeping our children. On the work and power.
Thank you.
want to have some friends, you got to show yourself friendly. Amen. Some of us ain't got no friends because we ain't friendly. Amen. Give the Lord a big hand offering. Next Sunday is T-shirt Sunday. Second Sunday is T-shirt Sunday. I'm reminding them, y'all just reminded me, the fifth Sunday we're going to say Merry Christmas to the pastor. The fifth Sunday we're going to say Merry Christmas to our pastor. The fifth Sunday. We usually say it on the second Sunday. But on the second Sunday, we'll be down at the Pastor Sam Church. So we're going to do it on the fifth Sunday. Mark that down. I'm sure the fifth Sunday crew, as I'm going up, we're going to celebrate, I'm sure. Thanksgiving, Christmas, something, they always got something going on. So we're going on the fifth Sunday. We're gonna say Merry Christmas to our man of God. Amen. Give the Lord just a big hand offering. Give a giver, say I'm a tither and a giver. Now, you know, again, the instructions you follow determine your life, right? The word God talks about, it talks about tithe and give. He says, bring all the tithes into my house. There may be meat in my house. Prove me here, would have said the Lord. So you want to open the doors of the heaven, pour you out a blessing, you won't have room enough to receive. Some of us have tried God and found him to be all right. How many have tried God and found him to be all right? Come on, tell that person next to you, I tried God and I found him to be all right. It works. The word of God said, bring all the tithes into your house. Let me meet in my house. Said, prove me, which said the Lord. See, when all the doors of heaven pour you out a blessing, you won't have room enough to receive. Said, I already read the vow for your sake. The vow cannot destroy through your ground. Your vine will not cast its fruit before one. All nations have called you. Yes, you're supposed to be like some people. Amen. Amen. Shout out loud, I am a tither. I tithe. Come on, I tithe. Because I tithe. The windows of heaven opened for me. God has poured me out a blessing that I don't have room enough to receive. We'll never come up against me. The Lord rebuke you. The Lord rebuke him. For my sake. Say, neighbor, it's harvest time around here. Come on, it's harvest time around here. Come on and say it with excitement because you know that you're expecting something, neighbor. It's harvest time around here. But you ain't saying it like you're expecting anything. Say, neighbor, it's harvest time around here. Say, neighbor. God's perfecting my timing. People see me, they call me blessed. They wondering how. I'm doing what I'm doing. It's because I am blessed. Come on, it's because I am blessed. Say, neighbor, Jesus said, give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, breast down, chain together, running over, shall be in give unto your bosom. I am a giver. Say, now look at your name and say, because I give. Thank you. against them. They can open up a pocket, somebody be pulling out. And it be a good pocket space. You ever had that happen? And people give God bread. Now, don't you be up here with God? You go say, now that's the favor of God. That's the favor of God. Amen. You ever had that type of faith and neglect? That's, you know, they listen. You listen. Let me get real. Let me get real, Coach Jackson.
Amen.
You had Popeyes and you won all the chicken.
Amen.
And they said, Graham, you batch your chicken up. Fresh chicken. Fried just for you. Now that's the favor of God. I know how I get in your neighborhood. I know how I get there. I know I get this. Don't you be acting like this. I know I. Oh, let me get even more common when you get the pig six. Then they just put out a fresh of pig six food. Five, anyway.
I'm Oh!
sing that song to the Lord. Spark the goodness of the blessing. And it's made from that. Man, lift your hand and sing the Lord's song. I keep the worship. What's your name? Lord, I love what's your name. I keep the worship for you, Lord. I pray for your name. We can't do nothing, you know. Magnify it, magnify it. Listen, listen. Make a name, make a show for God. Sound, stop the beat, clap your hands, lift the mic. Hallelujah. Come on and praise him. Lord, it's made for this. Back to all the love for your people. Give it out of what's his heart. Come on, lift it up. Lord, I'm just a sinning mercy. And it's waiting for this. Yes, Lord. Wash up my hand. I'm praying in his holy name. I take the water from you, Lord. For you have been in the mouth of the weak. Make it a place for me. Wash up my hand. I'm praying in his holy name. We can't do what you do, Lord.
Jesus, you love him. Lord, I love you. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. My God. Yes, Lord. Yes to your word. Yes to your word. Oh, tell him yes to your word. For he is good. Reach your hand with someone. Lord, we pray and stretch those hands and touch your people around the world. Bless them, oh God, especially your special vehicles. We ask you to do it now. Touch lives and make a change in them. God, give your people the blessing. We ask you to do it right now. Lift those hands towards heaven and give God another glory hand clap. When you shout yes, with a knowledge you can, yes, Lord?
Yes, Lord!
Oh, baby, young Jack, come on. Come on, open up the lungs, open up a little bit. Come on, let's do it again, loud as you possibly can, come on.
Yes, Lord!
Amen, that's better. That's better than that. Hey, you may have your seat as you possibly can. How many of you are glad for the Lord? How many of you glad for the Lord? I want you to do so. I want you to witness, amen, to five of your friends on your cell phone. Tell everybody to listen to the service that. If you have five friends, you want you to witness to them. Invite them to listen to me, the temple church of believers. Amen. Amen. Do a little witnessing. Let that telephone, amen, be useful today. Can you say amen? How many know the Lord is precious and he's good? Amen. Amen. For the Lord loves his children. And the Lord loves you. Aren't you glad that God loves you today? Amen. Rain a little bit outside, but that don't make no difference. God will see him inside. Amen. Amen. I thank you, amen, the Lord is blessing his people. Amen. Amen. And the 178th Psalm, amen, you find our lesson for the day. And God in this lesson here is telling moms and dads, parents, teach their children. That may be why you're missing that. What were you missing? Amen. And amen. We got to quit. Amen. We've started the boy, we're waking all the way back up. Amen. We're going to teach you. We will not hide them from our children. It's a first three. Which we have heard and known, our fathers told us. We will not hide them from our children. So that, amen, the word of God that teaches children. I mean, amen, amen. The breakdown is going to be the children. Amen. You see, amen, we got a problem. Amen. The problem not in having a degree you have, it's a problem that we are neglecting to teach our children about the fear of the Lord. Amen. Do you remember, amen, in the 50s and 60s and what have you, if you remember those days, we didn't have the problem we have with our black kids. Wasn't nobody in prison, wasn't nobody in jail. Because we were teaching. Can you say amen? Teach your children. Show to the generation to come the praise of God, of glory. And his strength, his wonderful work that he has done. Show them what God has done. Miracles and signs. I mean, tell them God. Amen. Put a fair. Amen. Let your children know that God is still blessing, still performing miracles. Amen. You know, amen. This is, amen. Because, amen, if our generation, our children forget about God, and think they're doing everything on their own, they're going to miss the mark. He said, teach your children, let them know he is God that does wonders. It's God that performing miracles. It's God that blesses you. Amen. Amen. Teaching that God is the blessing of the Lord. Because, amen, without the blessing of the Lord, you're going to miss the mark. 1, 2. Why? Because you feel you make it on your own. And you aren't going to make it. You're going to wind in trouble. But the reason, amen, most of us made it, I mean, most of us got that foot we got in life is because, amen, that we knew that God could help us. If you don't know God can help you, you're in trouble. Amen. If you don't know that God can perform miracles for you, you're in trouble. Amen. Amen. You can't do it on your own. You don't have to be a push. You don't have to be a yourself. No. You don't have to, amen, get out, amen, and prostitute your life. Well, you don't have to do none of this stuff. God can help you to make it. Amen. Teach your children, amen, his strength and his wonderful work that he has done. He established the testimony of Jacob and the law in Israel, which he commanded our fathers that they should make them known to their children. Make them known what God has done to the children. Why? Because that's the generation going to be after a while. Even in this church, that's the generation going to be ruled that way. Your children. Right. Old folks going to move on. Children going to be here. Huh? Oh, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So if you don't put no, if you don't teach your children about God, time to come, we'll be running a church without God. And this is what he's saying. You got to teach your children, because the generation don't, and the generation going to take over. And if this generation take over that don't know God, we're going to be in trouble. So teach your children. Ain't this what I'm saying? Amen. And they should make them known to their children. And generation to come might know. See, that generation come, I know what? Know what God can do? Know what God's a living one? Know what God's a healer? Know what God's a liver? Even the children which should be born. Those which ain't born and hadn't even come into the world yet. Well, you teach your children, then, amen. Your children are going to teach those that come into the world. So even those that haven't been born yet, praise God, who should arise and declare them to their children. Amen. They're going to arrive and go tell their children. And that's the way miracles and signs and wonders, amen, and all, amen, is why God can perform miracles, is because if one generation grows. Amen. If that one revival to another one, amen, praise God. Amen. We got caught up, amen, in the reality revival and the mighty miracle waking revival, what God could do and how God could perform miracles to heal the sick, raise the dead. Amen. And we simply believe it. So you got to teach your children so they will believe. And once you start believing, you start to get obedient because you want something to happen in your life. See, the reason why you're not obedient because you don't want nothing to happen in your life. You're not really concerned about what you do or what you do or what you don't. Amen. But I got caught up in the revival because when I saw what God was doing, I wanted God to do something in my life. Amen. I wanted God to work some miracles for me. I want God to move in my life. Amen. Then I began to seek the Lord, amen, because I was concerned about myself. Because if those things could happen, I could help make them happen. Yeah. This is what he said, you teach your children because until you see, amen, that you can be a part of what's going on with God and what God wants to do in the last days, amen. Praise God, amen. So God can bless your life. Take to me, amen. Let them know that God's still in the middle where you did. Amen. And clap, and they're going to rise up and clap unto their children. And they may set their hope in God. Why go through it? That they have a hope in God. See, you know, young men, amen, doing all this stuff. And I know, amen, maybe you don't like my teaching. But, amen, I believe that if you teach a child or you train your children right, I believe, amen, they'll make something like that. I honestly believe if your mom would stop and, amen, take time out. Come on, you go to the ball game with them, yeah? You can play ball with them, you should do with them. But how many times do you sit down and teach about what God can do in their lives? What God wants to do in their lives? Understand what I'm talking about? What God wants to do for them? Because they're going to be the generation, amen, they come. So, he said, teach them, amen, because God is the, amen, he's not a one-day generation. He's not a one-day generation, God. He's a God for one generation, another God, doing the same thing. And the same God works out in Genesis, amen, going to work all the way through the Revelation, and he's going to perform miracles until he comes back for the church. Teach the children. They may set their hope in God. And not forget the works of God. See, how many of you forget? Yeah. See, this is what God did, amen, for this church, what God did in our time. It's not all God wants to do. Yeah. Huh? God blessed the church and brought it this far, he wanted to carry it on. Amen. You know when you sit back now, amen, and thank God can't do nothing else. God has stopped performing miracles, God has stopped healing the sick, God has stopped raising the dead. God is doing the same thing now as he was doing in the beginning of time. That's why he said, I want you to teach your children that they might know that God is doing the same thing today as he was doing on yesterday. See me? Amen. And not we should be slack, amen, and thinking that we just come to church just to be coming. But we should know in our heart that we come to church to meet God. Yeah. Amen. In the Bible, the angels took, amen, they were just, my God, he just went before them on a pillar of cloud, and amen, praise God, in the daytime, the night, a pillar of cloud that got on fire, amen, night, he was so real. Teach your children, they may set their hope in God. And not forget the works of God. But keep his commandment. But keep his commandment. Amen. Now, this life is more to it than what you think. Money is good. Thank God for money. Thank God for money. And we all of us here know money. If it ain't have a right, you get in trouble. You see, money is good. Don't ever fool yourself about money. Money is good. But if you don't have a fear of God in your heart, money will get you in trouble. Amen. That's why he say you need to teach your children. Amen. Not, amen. Not just to respect God, but respect what God do for them. Respect the blessings of the Lord. Can you say amen again? Well, y'all don't hear me now. Amen. Amen. I get the word of God. But keep his commandment. It might not be as their father, stiff-necked, rebellious generation. Stiff-necked and rebellious generation. Amen. So God, the middle between, you see what God did. Amen. A lot of the old folks, they didn't believe God. God killed them out and being raised up to, from 19 years up. Amen. They did believe God. Right? So now, amen, what a time, they time, and I pray in our time, pounds that they believe God, sure as hell won't do what I want to do. See, and they are the generation that go room are going to be an authority. Huh? And the Bible says when the wicked rule, huh, there ain't more. Huh? Amen. I don't care what it was when the White House and the Black House. When the wicked have authority, the earth and the people don't know. Can you say amen again? Amen. I'm going to skip down just a little. Amen. That's what he wanted to teach me. Praise God. Amen. They keep not the covenant of God and refuse to walk in his law. Oh, I say, I ain't going to keep it. I ain't going to walk in the law. I'm not going to do it. The other way, I'm going to do what I want to do. Amen. And what he's saying here, that your lifestyle should be built upon what the Bible teaches rather than what the world is teaching.
Amen.
Well, getting our young folks in trouble, you know, amen, and turn to the world instead of turning to God.
Yeah.
And what the world is teaching, now come on now. The styles of the world, the fashion of the world, the fame of the world, amen, and getting our youth in trouble. Can you say amen? But what the Bible is, what God said, amen, we need to get their hearts turned back to God. Put the fear of God in their heart. Put the fear of God in their soul. Put the fear of God in their life. That they might just thank God. Have God. Amen. And we see all this stuff happen, amen, but it don't change our mind. Because we feel like our children wrong. And we just gave them over to them. But no matter how old they are, you still owe them teaching. You see, if God hasn't done anything for you, you ought to tell your children about it. If God has blessed you in any way, you ought to make it known to your children that God is still alive. He's still the Father knew. He still set the captain free. He's still making a way. Hallelujah. It ain't no time for sacking. The time, amen, to pull up and say, I want to believe in the God that is still performing miracles. And he said, yeah, they would get to teach him. He said, pray that deep. And how God, he divided the sea and caused them to pass through. And he made the water to stand up here. Over John said, tell them about it. How did they walk across the Red Sea on dry land? The water just took another heap. God performed the miracle. Now let me tell you, and this is the kind of God that we're serving. Make known to them that you're not serving a weak God, but you're serving a powerful God. You're serving a God that can, amen, depart the Red Sea. And cause the people to walk across on dry land and cause the water to stand up of the heat. Then why would you tell them, praise God? Explain to them that God is a big God. You're not good today about bringing them back to God. I mean, amen. And I'm sure, amen, if everybody here could really think. And you're losing a whole generation of black men. Amen. Every time you turn around, you see black men going to prison, killing somebody, stealing, robbing. Oh, y'all may shoot somebody. Oh, y'all may not. But if we have parents who stop and sit down with our kids and our children and teach them the fear of God. Teach you what God want to do. Teach you what God is doing. Come on now. Instead of saying, oh, I know you pray for them when they go to jail. You go and see them. That's good. But I know why don't you teach them where to get in jail?
That's right.
And seven times and look, amen, God is still God. God is still real. God is still a living, waking God. God wants you to be saved. God wants you to have eternal life. And then God wants you to be blessed. God wants you to be delivered. God wants you to have peace. Amen. I think, amen. This is where you tell me what I want you to tell me. Amen. In the daytime, oh, so he dead now with a cloud. That was when he looked up and he said, God was real. Your cloud, man, your little cloud. Amen. And all the night was a light of fire. They knew God was still there. God was daytime for the cloud. Nighttime for the cloud. Come on, amen. So there God is. There God is. Daytime, there God is. At nighttime, there God is. Amen. He stood there, amen, that they might see him and they might know he hadn't left them and hadn't forsaken them. He was still with them. Amen. Praise God. Night and day. Do y'all get that? And day and daytime also he let them with a cloud. And all night with a light of fire. My God. Yeah, God. To teach you how real God is. Come on, I know this is why we need to know how real God is. God is the amen, praise God, amen. So when you may not see him, you may not be able to feel him. But let me tell you that you could not only feel God, but you could also see God. Hallelujah. You may not saw it face to face, but you can see that pillar cloud. That cloud, amen, on fire. Come on now, somebody say, there God is. See, in that glory to God, they found the pillar cloud, amen. And he said, he's still here. He ain't going nowhere. He ain't left me. Praise God. Everybody said, I will never leave you, not forsake you. Lord, I'll be with you always. Right now. When you teach me, God is always with you. Amen. God is always there. Come on now. God is always present. God is always, amen. And you always, no matter where you are, you're in the presence of God. Everybody trying to say, amen, tell them that they're always, whether you're right or wrong, you're still in the presence of God. And you can't get away from his presence no matter where you go or what you do. No matter what happened in your life, you're always going to line up in God's presence. But that nowhere that God's presence is. His presence is anywhere. Can you say amen? And somebody said, I make up my bed in hell, there, there. If I take the wings of the morning and cry away, as you see it, don't be there. So nowhere you can go where God is. God's everywhere. Can you say amen again? Amen. Even though, amen, we may not tell them, amen, that God sees everything you do. Amen, God, amen. Come on, I know it. It's good or bad. God knows exactly what you're doing. God sees you good. God sees you bad. Amen. Why? Because he's still God. He said, the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth, the whole good and the bad. Because he's still God. Can you say that again? God sees everything, praise God. And God, amen, say, God is watching over me. They say that angels, amen, and what do we have? Oh, that's wonderful. Amen. Praise God. Cleaned the rock in the wilderness and gave them drink out of the drinking. Cleaned the water, the rock, dry rock, and gave them water to drink. It said water ran down like a river. Amen. Moses told Moses, speak to the rock. A dry rock. And water came out of the rock. This is where you want to know, amen, God is still God. Amen. And it doesn't take, amen, they all of the 3 million people needed a drink of water. And God said, speak to the rock. And Moses hit the rock. Water a good shot of rock. Praise God, and it ran down like a river. Oh, y'all hear me out of dry rock. Amen. Let them know, amen, God is God. See, this is why he got his name as being God, is because he's God. And what happened? He can take nothing and make something out of it. Come on, he don't have to, amen. It don't have to be something out for God. It don't have to be water for God to give you water. God can, amen. God can give you water out of a dry rock. And that's just like, that's what I'm saying here. God can give you a best one that has no way for you to get this. God can make a way for you, maybe when there's no way of it, that way for me. You don't have to, God don't have to, amen, have a way. See, God is the way. See, he is the way. Amen. It doesn't have to be, amen, a job. Whenever God gives you a job, he is the job. See, God is the way. They say, I am the way. I am the truth. I am the life. Amen. So he's not, amen, just, that's why he say he's God. He said, tell him I gave him water to drink out of the dry rock. And all this was, amen, to increase their faith. To build up their faith in God that they might have a hope in God. See, amen, the trouble is with the church, oh my God, we had church. But we don't have the hope in God and believe that God can. We don't believe that this God that we're serving is alive. We not admit that the man did that said God is dead. Yet he put out a song and he asked me if he was uninspired. That God is dead. He's a dead God. Another guy had to bring back another son and say, God ain't dead. I failed at this moment. He's alive. So if God ain't dead, he's still alive. If you fail in the teach your children, you remember this. You know, when they get in trouble, you'll be part of the blame. You'll be part of the blame of what they need. Because you could have helped those children. Huh? And if you didn't help them, if you didn't do what you could do, you're going to be part of the blame. Or you might go to say, amen. And well, I had a heathen. I can't. No. I'm going to tell you. Amen. And you, when you sit there and look at it, and you're going to get something to give 99 years on the black sun. Yeah. That's a sad feeling when you could have helped that boy. You could have helped that girl. But halfway, part of halfway, parents and teach that children you today. I said, parents are teaching their children how to be rebellious. Because if you write in your heart and your child do something, says something wrong, you rebuke them. You have to train them out. You know, if you're taking pause with your child, you're just bad on your child. Child is living your life. Amen. It's what he said, and teach your children. Amen. How many know that? This is the main thing. Teach your children how to love the Lord. Teach your children how to be obedient to the Lord. Teach your children, amen, praise God. And God is a miracle worker. Teach them not to be rebellious. Not to be stubborn-hearted. Teach not, hey, come on, amen, praise God. And you look at the boy and say, you just like your daddy. What if your head straightened out? Come on, amen. Amen. Really, life, amen, for the youth is not fine. It's a reality. Because we're living it every day. You leave your purse in your car, you're living. You leave something in your car, amen, in your door, you're going to live. Can you say that again? And this one made things real because we got delivered. You didn't go to the house, amen. Praise God, they tied him up. So you see, amen, you understand what I'm talking about? And that, and we said, well, amen, ain't nothing going on. You just gonna just leave your house open. Amen. When we, amen, you people used to sleep in the door though. When they were teaching at church. Huh? They ain't like lock up their house. Amen, leave the door open, go to church. Amen, praise God. Now, and I didn't lock in the door. But now, amen, we've got so many parents, amen, have teaching children. And some of the children are still the parents taking the money and spend it. You should have said, now tell the boy you're wrong.
That's right.
Tell him, amen, you're doing something you shouldn't be doing. They be a part of it. Can you say amen again? Oh, y'all over here, we talking. Amen. You don't look by yourself, your own child out there. What are you doing with the amen to the $1,000?
That's right.
Mama spent that money. Oh, y'all may be saying, isn't it? This is what happened, amen. Read why God said that to Moses, amen, said to the Simon, tell the people they need to teach their children. Don't hide the word of God, the truth from their children. Tell their children the truth, think you say, amen. Let them know the way to the sin and death. Amen. Let them know, amen, praise God, destruction is our thing. Teach them, amen, the right and teach them the wrong thing to say that again. Why? Because we're living in a day and this generation is going to be the generation to take over. Amen. Come on, are you listening to what I'm talking about? Amen. How you, amen. How do you understand? You have been, how do you understand me? And they that come, amen, children that rebel in this church, they be your pastor. This is what I'm trying to say. Tell you now. Those children, amen, they're going to be your trustees. They're going to be your deacons. Y'all hear me preaching now? Can you say amen? So that makes it a little more serious than we think it is. Can you say amen? The generation that, amen, that rebelled, they're going to be the generation that ruined. They'll say, amen, praise God, well, we're over, and you're over, we're not, we're going to sleep. You ain't going to live here forever. Can you say that again? You better tell a breath and good sleep, because you're going to die. We all going to die. Amen, we're going to die. Can you say that again? On our way out of here, can you say that again? We just need to raise up some good folks behind us. Raise up some good folks, amen, that will live the life after we're done.
Amen.
Don't think like you live there, but you ain't gonna live there. Can you ain't gonna live there, praise God. But try to raise up your children, amen, that they might, amen, make a mark in life. Make that they might be able to stand out in life. Amen. How many know that you? Amen. We look at it, amen, from another angle. We look at it from a way. Praise God. You trust you don't get old. You gonna need somebody else. Huh? That's true. You look at it and say, oh my God, I don't know what to be good. No, baby, you ain't gonna be your bill. Can you say amen again? Amen. So let's face it back to this way it said. Amen. Teach the children the word of God. Teach the children how to believe in God. Teach the children that God is still a God of deliverance, a God of miracles and signs and wonders. He's still the same. God has not changed. He's the same God of yesterday. I mean, that's what we not got. Thank you, my dear. Yeah, amen. Are you listening to me? Can you say that again? Amen. Teach them how to be good children. Teach them how to, amen, believe in God. Amen. Teach me how to live, glory to God. Praise God. It's a miracle. Yeah. Come on, God. See, the God that we should, amen, even what you want us doing, let you know that God is still doing the same. Huh? God performed miracles through me. He did all kinds of miracles. Amen. But God wants to perform miracles through you. Amen. God want to bless your children. Can you say amen again? God want to bless not just to be successful in money. He doesn't necessarily want you to have a nice house. He doesn't necessarily have you, amen, want you to drive the best car. But he wants you to believe that he is God.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Amen. And you might set your hope in God. And maybe sometimes we get our mind too much on money. Can you say amen? And take our mind off of God. We make two jobs to make money, three jobs to make money. We're lying, we're cheating, we're stealing to make money. Come on now. But we need to realize that the God that we serve is able to provide for us. They would not leave us alone. God would not leave you alone. If you serve him, you have more in your head in your life. Amen. I say you have more than you ever had in your life when you serve God. Hallelujah. Amen. This is what he's trying to get over to. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Glory to God. But then he said, amen. Now he's 17. And they sin yet against him. I provoke in him, both in the Most High and the Word. And they tempted God in their heart by asking me for that lust. God was doing everything for them and giving everything, but they tempted God. Amen. So you don't have to tempt God. Amen. They tempted God in their heart. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Yeah, they spoke against God. They said, can God punish a tape in the woods? Can God put a limit on it? Put a limit on God. He said, when you take the limit off, God teaches you. Take that limit off of God. God can do anything. There's nothing that God can't do. Can you say that again? God can prepare a tape in the woods. God can prepare a table. David said he prepared a table in the presence of my enemy. In the very presence of my enemy, David said he prepared a table in the presence of my enemy. Glory to God. It's a God can. I'm going, amen. This is what, amen, the church has put a limit on God and say, can God? We put a limit on God, and this is why, amen, God is saying to the church, amen, teach your children the word. Let them know that God can do anything. Let them know that God can depart the Red Sea. Let them know that God, amen, can give them food to eat. Let them know that God can work miracles. God is still putting meal on the bell. Glory to God. I'm talking about God is still with me on a bell. God is still, amen, praise God, bless you. You don't have to say to yourself, cheat, God is in the rest of me. That's why I always say, God is in the rest of me. You don't have to take that to God is in the rest of me. You don't have to steal nothing, God is in the rest of me. Amen, I believe in God that you steal, you let you find something. Oh, come on now. God is still blessing. Can you say that again? Come on. I said, you put your heart right in God. Amen. Praise God. He will you let you steal something. You let you find something. Why? Because he's God. He's concerned about you. He's concerned about your welfare. He's concerned about you believing him, trusting his word. He's concerned about you believing that he can do the impossible because God can do the impossible. But when I say they look in our day and time, God can turn the table around. Can you say that again? God can, amen. God can do anything. So I said, well, God, no, yes, God can. Amen. Praise God. Yes, I've been. Thank God. Yes, I've been. You said, yeah, I said, yes, I've been. No matter how, I said, yes, I've been. Come on now. All you need to do is wake up. Come on now. I'm telling you now. Wake up, mom. Wake up. You're heavy today. Don't be saying the day it should. You got when you get home. Now, get your Bible sometime. Teach him. Teach him the thing of God. Teach him how what God can do for him. Teach us now teaching your children what God wants to do in their life. He said, even when, amen, before they eat bone, teach them before they get here. Mother can talk to a child before you get in. I know that sounds impossible to unread, but he said, you can eat train a child before you eat bone into the world. Just start talking to mother, just start talking to him. Tell him, come on, God, talking to him. Amen. He can listen to the head even if we're still in the room. Oh my God. Amen. So you start training. Training don't just start when you get up. Training should have started when you were born. When you came into the world, you should start training that child. Can you say amen? And then if you hadn't got all the fit yet, you need to stop right now. Come on now. I know, amen. Praise God. It might sound unreasonable. But the reason why, amen, sometimes we have children rise up at our home and kill them because we ain't teaching. They rise up and kill you. Rather in your own house, amen, you said that with a Bible. They always come from somewhere. Amen. You need to come out of that home. Amen. You need to get out. Amen. Come on now. And you need to break through to the Holy Ghost and say, God, anoint me with some strength. Anoint me so I can teach my children right from wrong. Don't grow up scared of your children. Amen. They should be scared of you. You don't be anybody scared. Let somebody else help you scared. Instead of another comfort, man, praise God, don't want something to do. He gonna get me tough. Pastor, man, he will. You're going to tell you sorry when you're behind the bar. I'm sorry, Mama, how I've been treated. You know, you're going to say that again tonight. And you say it down again. And I've learned one thing. People get in trouble, they don't always change. You change people at home. You change it by teaching them the way they are. People make these vows in prison, they don't always keep it. They just tell another lie. Oh, he's a preacher. He's a preacher. Oh, he's going to be changed. She's going to be changed. No. Hey, prison will change him. God change him. God change him. God knows when they can change a man's heart. God knows when they can change the woman's heart. Come on, God knows when they can break down the stuff of nature, amen, and straighten it out. Nobody but God. God is the only one that can straighten out. He was the only one that can straighten me out. I couldn't even straighten myself out. God can straighten me out. God can straighten you out. Praise God. This is what he's saying, man. Just celebrate God. Fantasy that God can. God can do it. God can straighten you out. God can make something out of you, boy. God can make something out of you, girl. God can make something out of you. You don't have to be what you are. Can you say amen? But if you sit down and do nothing, you hadn't done your part. Can you say that again? You hadn't told them the truth. Instead of throwing on the truth, I told my children the truth and I never changed from what I told them. I didn't tell them one thing and the other no. I did the same thing I told them. Now, you out there living the same day they living. And trying to tell you, tell them the truth. They putting that stuff on you. And you're going to try to tell them, I'm going to straighten them out. You ain't going to straighten nobody out when you're doing what they do. That's why most of the children ain't done no better, because you ain't done no better. You all right in church? Yeah. You get out of church? Yeah. preaching? You ready to go to heaven too? They expect no children to respect the Lord. Can you say amen again? Come on, I'm telling you the truth. The reason why mom, dad, and your children are not respecting you is because you're not respecting yourself. You respect yourself, the children don't respect you. But when they see some little head you let down, are you this one thing? You get on rescue for doing what they want to. Now, y'all men out there, we're not talking to you anymore. We're going to teach your children how to believe God. Teach your children how to trust God. Teach your children how to live holy. Teach your children how to live a clean life. Teach your children how to obey God. Teach your children how to be obedient to God. So teach your children. Don't hide the truth from your children. If you know where they're going, they may not be disobedient, tell them. You know what life is going to be like if they don't disobey, tell them. Ryan said, amen, praise God, maybe things don't work out for me. You know, ain't nothing going to work out for disobedient folks. Come on now, I'm not preaching something on that, but a man gonna preach for himself. It's okay, amen, if you been doing bad, man gonna bother you. Can you say amen? Ain't one thing I know, straighten your life up. Believe God. Lord, I know you can. Y'all hear me today, I know you can. Believe in this Bible, but he ain't God. Amen. What he said. And well, he amen. He said that when he never was there, they lived by it. And they was blessed. Can you say amen? And I'm serious. Amen. Praise God. Amen. People live by the Bible and talk to their children and tell them to Sunday school and drown in rain. I didn't even know nobody was in prison. Everybody was doing good. One man that killed somebody. Why? Because they're teaching. What's happening now? Nobody teaching their children. They raised a bunch of wild kids. Everybody talk wild kids. Huh? Wild kids, they're wild dogs, biting folks. Wild kids killing up their babies. I mean, I'm saying, well, no. We're raising wild kids. Y'all may not go along with me, anybody, but you know it's true. You can probably get caught on the block, somebody to take it. Come on. But what we need to do is stop. One make a difference. You can't teach but one of the kids. And again, I know it's in life, and I'm telling you this. In every family in life I ever known, somebody in that family at home. They've been having one home, but somebody gonna be home. Out of that family. One person out of that family gonna be saved. Everybody gonna be saved now. But somebody gonna be saved, and all your children ain't gonna be the best, but some of them will be better than teachers. Can you say amen again? Some of them are not quite as hard as you think to be. Can you say amen? So you just need to get that old-fashioned Bible and that old-fashioned time and take some of your time. I know, and I ain't nothing wrong with you screaming anymore, good about me, I know. But y'all give God some of that time and try to raise the truth. But they don't want to go astray with you. Can you say amen? You may not know it can catch a straight ball, but you can catch where you do it. Can you say amen again? Amen. Set up in the bleachers, all right. But your heart going to bust, amen, when you get in trouble. Can you say amen? And deep down in your heart, Father, you know that you're part of the plan.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. You're part of the plan. Well, you would be at that church. But you know why you might be at that church? You sit down and talk to them about church.
Uh-oh. Look out
now. Preacher said something to him, and you sit down and think inside. Yeah, he was wrong. Somebody else was wrong. Some of y'all made y'all children like that.
Yeah.
Don't get mad with me. Can you say amen? You made your children rebellious. By not standing up to that child. When he stood against the preacher, you stood with him. You should be standing against him. You should be standing for right. That was dealing with the saints of old, amen. They stood for right. Come on, God. And one pair down there whooped your ear, another whoop. You've all got two whoopers. Mike got three whoopers. Oh, y'all don't hear me now. Amen. Ain't glad you would have shot God. I'm glad I behind closed those bad mouths. Oh, y'all been out like that. Bad mouthing. So when you bad mouth the preacher, his hope is in the preacher. And if you kill the preacher, he ain't got nothing else to believe in. Come on, he can send me all he wants to. When you have found kill the preacher, your jury ain't got anything else to believe in. Amen. Amen. Why, amen? He said, well, I'm going to go to prison, but I ain't going to do nothing. You better not ask me to do nothing. You didn't say, I'm the Lord is going to rip you. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Come on now, it's true. Why? Because you see what's going on. The mom was dead and having a hypocrite. And hiding in their heart. Amen. So you ever notice when you see a child where at? Your mom and dad been talking? That child come there ready to slap you. Do everything. Spitting on you. Your mom and dad been talking about how you done. You better not be my child. You better not say nothing to my child. Y'all look like this when I'm preaching anyway. Around the world. For the time, amen, that we need to realize that we can make a difference in our children. We can make a difference in the life they live. Whether they grown, amen, or not. You can start out and tell them the truth. If you know the truth. Amen. But Jesus ain't your little truth and the truth shall. Do what? Make you free. Stand to your feet. Because God, he just coming anyway. Amen. What is it? What is it? God is a good God. All the time. Amen. God got the children. Amen. Somebody want to do right. Amen. Hey, I want to pray for the children. You that hey, you want to do right. Hey, young people, you want God to do something for you. You have a mind to do something for God. Just come down. I want to pray for you. Come in, the Lord. Just give me. I want you to know that God is still God. Amen. Because I feel like these young people are going to be tomorrow. You're going to be out with young people and preachers and missionaries. Can you say amen again? Their life for tomorrow, praise God. It's going to be what, amen, you're looking for. Can you say amen again? Don't be your children, amen. They want to be obedient to the Lord. They want to do for the Lord. And I believe in my heart, amen, that God, amen, be children. And I mean, these children are not bad children. I believe they're good children. Deep down in the heart, I believe they're good. I believe they're good, good, good. I read as a good in every child that's here. Can you say amen? But I believe that one thing, I'll children. I believe that you all realize you can do better. Amen. You're going to grow up to be great, a missionary, or are you going to grow up to be a supervisor on your job? The both of them, amen, you're on your job, amen. I've been telling you one thing and you didn't do it, right? When you get on your job, you know what you're going to do? You're going to do the same thing. And you just don't disrespect me, they're going to disrespect you. You don't want to make it your own way up. Make your own way up. Because the thing you do in life is the thing that you'll follow you. Follow your life. Amen. That's why God loves you and you need to be better. Because tomorrow, you just think about that. Amen. Think about what kind of life you're going to live. Praise God. What kind of rebellion is it? Amen. But God, amen, is still God. We're going to pray for these children. Can you say that again? Amen. All these children, these are y'all children. But we're going to pray for them that God will bless these children. How many of God want to bless the children? Can you say amen? But children, let me tell you this. It's important that you be strong enough to follow the rules. Revelation. That was a problem. The difference between me and you, when I got saved, I could follow the rules of the church. I ain't no problem. I had no problem done with the world. When I got saved, I gave up the ways of the world and followed the ways of God. And that's what you're going to have to do the same thing. You think that these little things are important. They're important things. You follow the rules of your church. Follow the teaching of your preacher. You see what I'm talking about? See, you pass away. I want to know all the time. All you will do like that, man. You ever seen a little children with me? All of them looking like they leave. Little boy with Bibles in their hand. White shirts and neckties. Can you say amen? Amen. Living respect for witness. Are y'all listening to what I'm saying? Yeah. See, but why we got, when we don't do what we want to do. See, nobody can do what they want. Everybody got to be served. Yeah. Y'all understand that? Served. Yeah. I have to be served, you have to be served. Yeah. We all got to be served. Yeah. See, that's the only way that you're going to be blessed. My way of in life, you may be a preacher. You may be a missionary. See, don't tell what you might be in life. See? The more you get in life, amen, you want to change the way you were doing. You'd have a hard time changing. That's why it's important to live the life that you want to change. See, y'all understand what I'm talking about? You children understand what I'm saying? This is him. Amen. Every one of y'all be doing something for the Lord. Amen. Why? All be doing something for the Lord. Rewards don't come for nothing. They come because you're doing something. That's why you get reward. That's what makes your day feel good. Is what you do. When you do it now, if you're not doing it now, and if you're doing rebellion and vex and boast, that's the worst thing you have. That's an instruction thing. See, that's the thing that came in that calling you to suffer. You rebel, you're calling you to suffer. See, when you rebel against the preacher, you're going to suffer. So, you suffer. He told me that when I was a boy, he said, you rebel against the preacher, you're going to suffer. You can't win. If you hear the preacher out there, you don't even have a church, you can't win. You better leave the preacher alone. You can't win. You mess with the preacher, you mess with not your back match. Preacher, not your match. Follow instruction is what you're supposed to do. Follow the instruction. For a mind to do. A mind to do. A mind to do. Not just tell me, I said, I'm up here, dog. We know what you'll be like. And a lot of times, money, taking money, depending on what you do now. Things that you do not. Oh, your attitude is going to have a whole lot to do with your life. Your life is dependent on your attitude. A bad attitude don't get you in trouble. Amen. I don't take much time to talk to you too, because I've been preaching to you. But when your attitude is straight up, your life will automatically be good. Good job. Come on, good things happen to you. Why? Because amen is nothing to do with on your attitude. Amen. And then he's gone by, amen. Praise God. Our pals, they told us amen. Yes, sir, no, sir. But nothing wrong with it, but it got us through life. How are we going to get you to find out? I mean, the way of the truth. And you say it now again. Amen. Amen. I'm going to pray for you. Amen. But I want you to understand, children. Understand? Dang. Dang, you're lying. You need to be doing something like that. We don't need to look down there and say, I hope you say no type when you're thinking out of it. You need to be already speaking. But all I got to do is just speak to the people. See what I'm saying? Say, okay, you're going to be a deacon. I'm sorry. Amen. I said, well, you ain't with it. You can't put a foot on something if you're not looking at it. You ought to be looking. You got to already be looking like that. And I said, I want training. You be training. They ain't got no mind to straighten up. They ain't going to straighten up. I mean, I'm saying, I'm going to talk about it. So we need to straighten our lives up now, praise God. And you're saying that again? Don't try to fucking kiss me. Amen. I got my life made. I've been living the Lord. You got to be good. If I go now, amen, God has been good to me. God has been good to me. Amen. And what reason been good to me, but I've been obedient. I've been obedient. The obedient child live a long life. This obedient child is happy. Just half. Can you say amen? Come in here and say, when you get behind me, I'm going to pray for them. And we get behind the children. We're going to pray, God. I'm praying, God, we just help these children. Help them. Help them to make the most important decision in your life. Yeah, yeah. Amen. Praise God. Amen. We're going to ask God, amen, to send forth the blessings upon these children. Amen. How many know God is real? God is real today. God is for real today. Can you say amen again? We're going to believe God. That God can stretch forth his hand. Amen. Boy, I know it. How many of you children got a mind to do better? How many of us? Go be yourself forever. How many of you got a mind to do better? Got a mind to do better. You just got to in your mind to do better. You ain't got no mind to do it. Okay. Well, don't you be wasting prayer if you ain't got no mind. You got to have a mind. If in your mind you do better, can you say mind? I'm going to give up the Lord. Tell me, I'm going to give up the Lord. We're going to shout out again. I want y'all to believe God. Can you say amen? Oh, God. Thank you, Lord. Wonderful Jesus. Glory to God. Bless this time. Change your name. Do it now, Lord. Now, Lord. Jesus' name. Name of Jesus. Jesus' name, bring him to the Lord. Now, God. Bless him in the name of Jesus. Fill him, Jesus. Now, Lord. Bless him in the name of Jesus. Now, God. Oh, God. Bless him in the name of Jesus. Jesus' name. Bless him in the name of Jesus. Jesus' name. Bless him in the name of Jesus. Change the name to the deliverance. Change the name, glory to God, and the deliverance. In the name of Jesus, bless the deliverance. In the name of Jesus, glory to God, bless the deliverance. Bless the deliverance. Glory to God, bless the deliverance. Change the name, bless the deliverance. Bless the deliverance.
Nobody in God can do it right now. Father God, we come in the mighty name of Jesus, knowing that you have all power in heaven and earth in your hand. After the strength, put your hand and touch. Change the life of young people. Change their lives and change their soul. Change them, oh God. Give a mind of your faith, God. Give a mind of your obedience to your Lord. Help them to say yes, Lord. Help them to say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Glory to God. We need to lift your hand to heaven. Let's give God some holy praise. Oh, you can have your seat if I can again. Oh, no. We're going to receive the offering. Hallelujah. God will. Amen.